2, beginning at verse 8, and this is the word of the Lord. Jesus is talking here to the church at Smyrna. The letter is addressed to the angel in the house. And unto the angel of the church in Smyrna write, "These things saith the first and the last, who was dead and is alive. I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them who say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Here's the part I really want to talk about tonight. But be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. He that overcometh shall not be hurt of a second death." Amen. Amen. I just want to talk about be faithful. Amen. This night we're talking about church leaders and rededicating ourselves to the Lord and installing new leaders for new Christian leadership. I just want to talk about being faithful. Because sometimes, brothers and sisters, we get caught up in a lot of things that God is really not looking for. Amen. Amen. God wants us out of all things to simply be faithful. Amen. That is, when you say what you're going to do, do what you say. Amen. Mean what you say. Say what you mean. Amen. If it's 2 o'clock, come on down here, 2 o'clock. Amen. The Lord wants us to be faithful. If you're the only one, then be the only one. If it's raining, come on out in the rain. Amen, somebody. Everybody gets headaches and stomach ache. Amen. Come on anyhow. We can't stop living. Amen. The Lord has made it possible for you to serve. He expects you to be faithful. Amen, somebody. Now, one of the things God has done when he has made you in or created a position for you to be in is he made a way for you to do what he had called you to do. Sometimes, brothers and sisters, you don't feel like doing what God has assigned you to do. But I declare, if you put one foot in front of the other, God will pick up the other foot and step it in front of the first foot. And the next thing you know, you'll be walking. In a few minutes, you'll be running. And after you run, you'll stop only to rejoice in the joy of the Lord. I'm here to let somebody know God is good tonight. And he expects us to be faithful. John is the writer of the text tonight. He writes the revelation of Jesus Christ. And he shares this with the 7 churches in Asia Minor. One of the blessings of this letter, if you read it in the first chapter, John writes about the 7 golden candlesticks all arranged around the presence of Almighty God. Jesus is in the midst of his church. I can't stress enough how he said, "It's my church." It is his church. He's not only in control of it, but he's got his eye on it.
I remember that time when the disciples were out on the Sea of Galilee being tossed to and fro with the waves of the sea. They didn't want to go, you know.
It was the second time, and Jesus had to almost lay hands on them to get them into the boat. And they're out there in the middle, and here we go again. Another storm.
Ain't God something?
Sometimes he'll make you repeat a prayer so that he can take you to a higher level. I like how Lord Jesus opens each letter to all 7 churches. He reminds them, he says, "I know what's going on. I know everything. I know your uprising and your downsitting. I know what you're in, I know what you're out of. I know the stuff that you don't think I know. I know what you're hiding from other people." Peace.
frustration. I know your disappointment. I know your load. I know the capacity of your ability to share.
I know
that Smyrna, they were going through some very difficult times. They were undergoing persecution at a level indescribable. Some were paying for their faith or their very lives.
Amen.
The Lord reminds them that he is first and the last.
Yes.
He said to John in the first chapter of Revelation, verse 11, he said, I'm Alpha and I'm Omega.
Amen.
Now, brothers and sisters, before we get carried away with that, we need to understand that Alpha and Omega is first and the last. Yes. First and last letters of the Greek alphabet. But it's deeper than just the first and the last.
Yeah.
He's gonna cast some strong in the midst of tribulation.